If you're planning to visit Dubai but your budget is limited, keep watching this video. Hey guys, welcome to Oksy Vlogs. If this is your first time here and you would like to know more information about life in Dubai, don't forget to hit subscribe button and the notification icon so you will not miss anything. We all know that Dubai has a lot of things to offer, so it's very easy to spend money here. When you're coming to Dubai as a tourist but you are on a budget, you might have a question: what places should I visit not to spend a fortune? So in this video I will share with you some places and cheap things that you can do in Dubai. First of all, I would like to recommend you to rent an accommodation or book a hotel next to the metro station. Dubai is not a pedestrian-friendly city, so if you don't have access to the metro station, you will spend quite a lot of money on taxi. Before you come to Dubai, I advise you to check out these two websites because they have a lot of coupons and they can help you to save money. But make sure that you make a reservation or booking in advance. Now let's talk about the places that I recommend you to visit. If this is your first time in Dubai, you definitely should visit Dubai Mall, Burj Khalifa and Dubai Fountain. All these three places are located in the same area, so you can visit all of them in the same day. Dubai Mall is the largest mall in Dubai. It's a paradise for people who love shopping, so you might spend the whole day there. There is also Dubai Aquarium and underwater zoo inside the mall. You need a ticket to go inside, but you can also see a lot of things just standing outside. Once you finish your shopping and you exit the mall, you will see Dubai Fountain. It's really beautiful. The dancing show starts at 6 p.m. and the last one is at 11 p.m. every 30 minutes. And right next to the Fountain and Dubai Mall, there is Burj Khalifa, the iconic building, the tallest building in the world. So you will definitely see it. If you want to go to the top, you need to buy a ticket. The entrance is from the Dubai Mall, so you don't need to go to Burj Khalifa itself. If you want to go to the top, the entrance there is from Dubai Mall, from inside. Just ask the security and they will guide you where you need to go. But if you want to save some money, you don't want to buy tickets, you can just take some pictures outside the mall, standing next to the fountain. Many people do that. The next place is called Dubai Marina. It's one of the most popular areas among tourists and residents, and you can get there by metro. Dubai Marina has a lot of beautiful tall buildings, artificial water canal with yachts, plenty of restaurants, shops. You can have a walk along the water promenade, you can rent a bike there and just have a ride around Dubai Marina. There are plenty of bike stations. So it's a really beautiful place and I highly recommend you to visit. Why this area is so popular among tourists? Because it has access to the public beach. It's just 5 minutes walk from the promenade. And when people come to Dubai, especially with kids, I recommend them to stay in this area because there are plenty of hotels, residences, accommodation that you can rent, and you have easy access to the metro, so it's very easy to move around the city. You have access to the beach and you can walk there just, and you have also a lot of restaurants, shops and supermarkets around you. So you can even stay in one area and you have access basically to everything. Once you reach the beach, you will see the tallest Ferris wheel in the world. It's called Ain Dubai. At the moment I'm filming this video, it's not operated yet, but you can go, it's located on Blue Waters Island, and you can go there just crossing the bridge from the beach, and it's free to enter. Everyone can go there to that island. The next place is my favorite public beach in Dubai. It's called Kite Beach, but you can get there by car or by taxi only. They have plenty of water and outdoor activities. A long time ago I filmed a vlog there, so you can check it out on my YouTube channel. You can bring all your own food, drinks, beach towels, and also you can rent a sunbed and umbrella, so it's up to you. They have a 7 km running track, so if you love running you can go there for a run. Also you can rent a bike and ride along the beach. So there are plenty of activities to do. Of course, they have a lot of restaurants and shop there. So if you want to buy food or drinks, you can do it. Don't worry, you won't stay hungry. So this beach is quite equipped. They have shower, they have restrooms, everything there. Now let's move to Palm Jumeirah. So the place that I recommend you to visit there is called The Point. It's a waterfront destination with a beautiful view of the iconic Atlantis Hotel. But why I recommend you to visit this place? Because they have the largest fountain show in the world there. It starts at 6:30 p.m. and the last one on weekdays is at 10:30 p.m. On weekends, I think at midnight. And now I'll share with you some historical places that you can find in the old part of Dubai. One of those areas is called Al Seef. You can get there by metro and then you need to walk a little bit. It's located in the historical part of the city and you can see how old Dubai looked like. It's quite Instagrammable. And also there is an interesting place, it's called the Museum of Illusions. You can check it out. You need to buy a ticket to enter, but it's an interesting experience. Overall, you can just walk around the area, it's a really beautiful place. The next area is Al Fahidi, it's the historical neighborhood located along the Dubai Creek. You can get there by metro and it's one of the oldest parts in the Emirates and they have a lot of museums and the textile market. Once you finish in Al Fahidi, I advise you to take the Petrol Abra boat and go to Gold Souk. The boat station is located in the same area in Al Fahidi and the boat tour one way cost only 2 dirhams. It's so cheap, but the experience is amazing. I highly recommend you. Gold Souk is a traditional market where you can buy jewelry. It's so popular among tourists, but if you're not planning even to buy anything, just go there. Imagine that you go to the museum. So you can visit Al Fahidi and Gold Souk within one day. So guys, these are the places that I recommend you to visit if you're planning to come to Dubai and you are on a budget. If you want to know more about this city, I have a lot of videos on my YouTube channel, so don't forget to subscribe and check it out. See you in the next video. Bye bye.